Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Jesus was the first coming of Satguru, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. So, the prophecy has been fulfilled. Now the last prophecy, when the end of the world come, I will bundle up the tear and burn them, and that is taking shape in Israel. And we are approaching the end of the world. But don't believe me. You have to search yourself. So here, here I'm writing a book on one God, one faith, and his chapter on Trinity, Gnostic Trinity, and the concept of the three worlds. Anybody interested in giving me a helping hand, it will be much appreciated. Milk, scriptures. You know, the scriptures are milk, which are gulped whole. And Christ Paul has defined it that now we are chewing milk, meat. To chew meat, you need teeth. And those teeth are Trinity and the concept of the three word. Milk scriptures is easy to gulp. But to chew meat, gospel, you need sharp teeth. Our discerning intellect. Trinity and the concept of three worlds are the backbone of religious knowledge, the Gnosis. And it is best learned through Holy Spirit or the common sense. Trinity has been much confused with the family of God, in which God is our Father, Holy Spirit is our mother, and the heirs to the royal kingdom of God are the sons of God. Remember that in Jesus we are, our Father is supernatural, which is of soul, and soul has no color, no gender. So the sons of God are those who are independent thinker, who are not stooges of any religious organization. They can think themselves, because you have to give your account to God yourself, not somebody else going to give. Jesus, being the first anointed Son of God, whilst the apostles, on receiving their rewards of Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit is a gift given to the apostles for working hard. At Pentecost it was given. They also became the twin brethren of Christ Jesus, the sons of Most High Elohim, Parbrahm, Allah, God, etc. Different names, you know, in different languages. Holy Spirit, with small s, is the spirit of man, which is common sense. And it is a rare gift of God, who are faithful to Yahweh. Brahma, we call him Brahma, you know, the creator of male and female. So everything you see with your two naked eyes belongs to Brahma, this one Brahma. But inside me belongs to our supernatural Father God. And therefore, the understanding of the principle of Trinity is not within the scope of all, but at the same time, those who grasp the concept of Trinity know how valuable is this concept in understanding gospel delivered by Christ Jesus. Now the religious books The scriptures are milk, contain dead letters, and therefore unless God gave you the spirit to understand the gospel hidden underneath the scriptures, you know, the root of the scripture is his oral Torah, which is his word. So if you can see the, if you can understand the scripture in the light of the root, then you can see the whole thing. And if there's any corruption made, you can darn it, you can make it correct. So underneath the scripture, you will be reading them as today the students of theology read in the universities to get their degrees and licenses for the dog collar to become hirelings, hireling priests in the churches of Mammon. Most of the churches you come across, they belong to Mammon because their priest, dog collar priest, is working for Mammon. Is not working for God. There was a retired vicar, and we had a program, big question on God, you know, and the presenter addressed him, Vicar David Patterson. He said, "Oh, no, no, don't call me vicar. I'm no more vicar. I'm retired." So he had to stop the program, restart it. So he, all the life, he was working for Mammon. And when he retired like a policeman. No common sense. So such stupid people, they are the one, you find them in the churches. Because if you want to preach gospel, you received Holy Spirit from our Father. Unless you get it from Him, you can't open your mouth. To give you an idea of the rarity of Holy Spirit, some clergy daubed the White Hall in London with charcoal that was blessed by the Bishop of Kensington some years ago. Now, such clerics worship in the temples of Mammon, such as the St. Paul's Cathedral in London, where statues of those Whitehall's heroes, the killers of men in wars, are displayed that helped in the establishment of the British Empire for the sake of Mammon. And there is not a single statue of a person who served the poor in the name of Jesus, even in the manners of Brother William Booth of the Salvation Army. So William Booth is out, Mammon is in, and they worship. Further, most of their churches also have plaques dedicated to soldiers who were killed during the wars, as to have glorified God, and the annual remembrance of dead soldiers of Mammon in their churches amply reflect that their God is in reality Mammon, not our God, loving and merciful. This is clearly reflected in the headship of the Church of England, which is Queen, the head of Mammon in Great Britain. No wonder she is also the defender of faith of such churches of Mammon. So what sense did it make to worship in the temples of Mammon and then go around dubbing the very institution of Mammon such as the White Hall? So you can see how intelligent these dark-colored people are. Further, God being love and service, we receive humane treatment from brethren in Jesus, whereas Mammon being kill and rule, we should expect inhuman treatment as the prisoners of war do receive. God being reliable and Mammon unreliable, the loyal soldiers of kings are mostly deceived. Kings are secular kings, and in Jesus we are royal king. Royal king are superior to the kings in money. So, do not be disheartened by the above facts of life that are apparent to the naked eyes, as this worship of Mammon is rampant all over the world. But still it is among the people of West that the light of God is said to shine. Matthew 24 verse 27. For just as the lightning comes from the east and flashes even to the west, so will the coming Son of Man, which was Satguru Nanak Devji, who came in 1469. So he came, second coming of Jesus, and nobody knows, because this knowledge is not common, it's rare. So please pluck courage to take on the cross of Jesus. So take the cross of Jesus to honor his blood, the gospel, and to fight the evil-spirited people by exposing their blasphemies or hypocrisies. That is what the gospel is for. Gospel reveals, exposes the hypocrisy, which is the darkness inside the crooks. That is why they don't like light, because their hypocrisy will be exposed. So I will leave it here, and then we will do it in the next.